What is up, people? BP here, and today we're going to be looking at how to be an alpha male, okay? Yeah, because being a beta male absolutely sucks. By the way, if you guys really and truly believe in this alpha male, beta male bullshit, you guys are retarded. Okay, because none of that crap actually exists. Either you have confidence or you do not, okay? Your life is not dependent upon whether or not you can bed beautiful women all the time. It doesn't matter, people, okay? That being said, we're going to go ahead and take a look at PewDiePie's little video on are you a beta male or not? And I think he probably views this sort of stuff just like I do. It's a complete joke. So we're going to take a look at this and just kind of, I guess, provide some commentary, people, because, yeah, nobody wants to be a simp living in their mom's basement, completely broke, and without a girlfriend. That sucks, okay? So here we go.
Not subscribe to PewDiePie.
Hello, Aluxers. Now, this Sunday video will make a couple of you guys cry because
not me.
You've been living in a bubble.
I don't think so.
To not bullshit yourself, right? To see reality for what it actually is.
What a patronizing bitch, okay? Just tell me.
Mel is an unremarkable, mediocre, careful man who avoids risk and confrontation. Beta males lack the physical presence, charisma, confidence. associated with winners in life.
I feel like these sorts of videos that I guess put down quote unquote beta males, it's almost like saying, ha ha, nanny nanny boo boo, I'm an alpha man and you suck on doo doo. I just feel like it just puts people down, like who maybe don't have a girlfriend or can't get laid. It's like, hey, man, look at me. I can get laid. I have beautiful women, and you suck. Don't you feel sorry for yourself? That's how I feel these kind of videos are, but yeah. That's why the whole alpha male, beta male shit is just total bullshit. As a matter of fact, I'm trying to get a t-shirt customized so I can sell it on YouTube. That I think would be really, really funny. And the concept would be like, stand back, peasant. I'm an alpha male, okay? Or stand back, peasant. I'm a beta male. So, anyway.
Probably thinking, well, that doesn't sound like me.
No, it doesn't.
I'm a winner. Not
at all.
Always have been, always will be.
Yes.
It's time to put that to the test. We made this video specifically for those of you who are struggling with this. We're not talking about gym lads who can bench press twice their body weight, but instead we're focusing on a more holistic approach. Some might even mention that there are other categories like gamma males and omega males.
I'm an infinity male. I'm above male. I rise above. Meta male.
Honest, if you're not an alpha, does it even matter what you call yourself?
Meta male, that's good. No one's coined that, right?
The capability to deal with the situation directly. It's enough to go to...
Oh my god, she keeps blabbing. 15 signs, let's go. Number one.
Here
what the
are 15 signs you're a beta male.
Jesus
and
Christ.
What to do about it. Number one. You don't feel like your life is getting better and better.
What?
The first...
Fuck, I'm a beta. God damn it. What? It has to always get better incrementally? That's ridiculous. That is dumb. Stop it. It gotta go worse to get better sometimes. Stop it, bitch. Stop it. No. Nah. Dumb. Dumb. What is number two? Skipping this. You never...
Doesn't life just kind of get worse for everybody? I mean, let's just suppose you're the most attractive, successful man on the planet. And you have just thousands of girls that you're betting every day, okay? Like, there still comes a day when you're going to turn like 78, 80 years old, maybe even 90 years old if you're lucky enough, and you're going to get old, wrinkly, bald, maybe even fat, and eventually you're going to die. So does it really matter if you're an alpha male or a beta male in life? I don't think it really matters. I mean, it's all about what matters to you. I mean, do you want to get laid? Is that important to you? And do you want to get laid with one woman or 1,000? I prefer one real good woman over like 1,000 mediocre women. I mean, that's just me. And yeah, I'll take my gorgeous girlfriend over like 100 different women any day of the week. But every now and then it is kind of like an itch I want to scratch where I want something different from time to time. And I think that's kind of normal. So, but I mean, if I'm going to sit here and feel sorry for myself, then maybe I just need a different hobby, okay? And that goes for you too. I mean, if you feel like you are absolutely unable to get laid, man, just get a hobby. Do something else. Find something else to do with your time besides focusing on getting laid. It's not that big of a deal, okay? So, all right, let's see what else PewDiePie has to say.
Never face your
form in childhood and stick around in your adult life. Most people get bullied.
Hey, you can't get bullied unless you never get bullied, okay? Why would I? Why I go back to school just to confront them? What am I supposed to do? And I was never bullied anyway, because you can't get bullied if you don't get bullied. Idiots. Dummies. Nah. Okay. Dumb. What? You never... What? Stupid.
This is
not
stupid.
A beta. This is dumb. This is so dumb. What the hell?
We're probably,
I'm sorry, I didn't...
We're probably all beta males and we just don't know it. It's like, oh, you've only been with 50 girls in your lifetime? Yeah, you're a beta male. Real alpha males only... Real alpha males bet at least 200. It's like, get the hell out of here, man. Nobody gives a shit. Let's continue.
And grow with supernatural powers like Spider-Man and started confronting people. Okay, what am I supposed to do? My point is, the best way to deal with bullies is to act like they don't face you, because they just want a reaction out of you, and they're taking out sort of bullshit they're dealing with onto you, or their insecurities onto you. So don't just don't engage with it, okay? Yeah, you're welcome. Can't get bullied if you don't get bullied.
You'll have to deal with them throughout your entire life.
Oh my god. All right, what's number three? You rely on others, like your family, to make decisions for you. Okay.
That's some beta male.
Is everyone going to be beta male in this way? I actually don't do this at all. Maybe it's a personality trait thing. I think it has nothing to do with beta or alpha, man. Number one sign of being a beta, you let people classify you, right?
Pretty much.
It seems like people always want other people's opinion, which I don't know. I'm like, bro, I don't know why you're asking me. It's your choice at the end of the day. I don't know all the nuances of the different outcomes of the choices that you are weighing. What the hell do you want me to do? I don't know. Stop letting other people make choices for you. Although, I mean, I did kind of go to university like my parents.
That, and stop classifying men as alpha and beta. Like, honestly, that shit does not matter.
Just wanted me to do so. You know what? Yes, I was a beta. Now I'm meta male.
Number four. You're physically weak.
No. You're physically weak. This is so real.
I mean, what is your definition of weak? Okay, so let's look up... What is it? See, there's two types of strength. You have strong, and then you have really strong. So it'd be like let's say the normal guy is Punisher, and then the alpha male is like this guy right here, the Russian. Okay, so who's... I mean, who's to say which is more attractive to women, right? I mean, like, if their definition of an alpha male is going to be the Russian, what about the beta male right here, who's like kind of average looking, minds his business, works out, he's a badass in his own right, okay? Nobody, he doesn't give a shit if he's an alpha male. Watch this show. This is like one of my favorite movies of all time, by the way. And this music rocks, dude. I don't even know what they're saying. What song is this? Does anybody know what song this is? Turn it up, people. I want to hear this. Let's get to the action. I forget this guy's name, but... Thomas Jane. He played Frank Castle. This was such a badass movie. And there was no, like, superhero, per se. It was just... It was just kind of like all regular people. If that makes any sense. Oh, damn. That's one hell of an alpha male. I mean, can you imagine if that's like some girl's boyfriend and he just like had sex with her the other day? This is the type of shit you'd have to deal with as a beta male. I think this guy in real life is 6'10", if I remember correctly. Oh, ouch. I hope YouTube doesn't, like, flag my video for this. Like, oh, you have to be at least 18. This is gonna suck, man. Oh, gosh. He's like, man, it's a sucky day to be a beta male. He's like, how dare you bang my Russian wife? Oh, shit. He's like, alpha males don't cry. He's like, if only I was not born freaking less than perfect. This is such a badass movie. I seriously just want to watch the rest of this and forget the beta male, alpha male shit. Because I really don't care. Hell yeah, guys. You guys are dancing like fairies and shit. Golly. I mean, Frank Castle is one hell of a badass for taking a beating like this. Can you imagine? He's so tired too. Can you imagine, man? That would suck. I would just want to go to sleep at this point. Shoot his ass. That's it. Nope. Denied. You should have been an alpha male, bro. All right. Needless to say, the Punisher wins that battle. But anyway, continuing with Mr. PewDiePie.
Ridiculous. Okay, if I want to entertain this concept of beta and alpha male, right? It all comes down to confidence to me. It has nothing to do with physical strength, right? Nothing. It's all confidence.
Physical strength is often a contributing factor in self-confidence. It happens to also be an indication of someone's health.
And if you are under the impression that you are more of an alpha male or some sort of cooler guy because you have muscles, and that's some dumb schmuckery fuckery as well. Then that's some beta shit. That's some beta brain.
If you're in the friend zone, you're probably a beta male. The truth is, most of you end up in the friend zone because all you do is act like a friend, not a possible partner or lover.
Ooh, it stings.
You've positioned yourself incorrectly, and now you're stuck there. But Alux, I'm in the friend zone because I'm too nice. I'm not a douchebag. No, you're probably not as nice as you think you are. Just because you think of yourself as a nice guy doesn't mean the world should see you the same way.
Well, no, just because she worded this completely wrong. Just because you are a nice guy doesn't mean anyone owes you shit, okay?
Right, exactly.
But I was nice to girl. Why she no let me pee-pee? I'm like, what? Just because you're a nicer person doesn't mean that you have any obligations whatsoever to you. So...
Plus, did you even try to ask if you could have sex with her? I mean, you have to, like, initiate and be like, hey, Susie, would you like to come over on Friday night? Let's hang out at my place. All right. And when she gets there to your place, make it, I don't know, make moves, man. Like, put the movie on, sit her on your couch for, like, 30 minutes to 2 hours. All I need is like 30 minutes, okay? 30 minutes to an hour, 2 hours tops, and I'm up in them guts. So that's all you need to do, man, is just initiate and bring her to your house, sit her down next to you on the couch, watch a movie. 30 minutes, an hour later, put your arm around her, freaking start kissing her, start feeling on her tits, feel on her pussy, and have sex, man. Like, make it happen. Don't just sit there and take the bullshit. Like, 5 hours later, she's still on your couch watching more movies, not giving you any pussy. Like, kick her ass out of the house. Don't be her friend, period. All right, forget that friend zone shit.
It's so entitled to imagine that, right? Listen. I don't do relationship advice often, but if you're into someone, it's better to tell them. And if you think they're gonna say
don't
no,
be a friend.
Don't tell them and just move on. Okay? Don't get stuck on one person. There's someone out there for you. Okay?
You cannot be friends with a woman.
No
Sorry.
Chance. But you got don't linger. I think that's the problem with people in friend zone. They do linger. Stop lingering.
Number 6.
Some people linger for years.
You can't say no and stand your ground. Beta males have a hard time saying no to other people.
This is a skill you have to learn, I think. I definitely was the kind of person that couldn't say no, and then you end up feeling miserable because you're doing a bunch of stuff you didn't want to do. It takes confidence, again, to say no. So, yeah, I actually agree with this one. Yeah. That's a good sign. Good telltale sign.
Some hide under the mask that, again, they're just being...
Yeah, you're definitely a bitch if you can't tell somebody no. No! No, please don't touch my no-no spot. No. Yeah, you're a bitch. Just kidding. Okay, bad joke, people. Gee whiz. As far as saying no, that just simply means, like, stand your ground, but, like, does that mean you're a alpha male or a beta male? No, man. Like, plenty of men say no, whether they're, you know, strong-willed or not. I mean, it really makes no difference. Anyway, let's continue.
Being nice or being a people pleaser.
And I wouldn't like people that can't say no to say yes either. Like, if I ask someone to do something and they don't want to do it, I'd much rather they say no anyway. So it makes no sense why you wouldn't be able to say no, in my opinion at least. Different circumstances, gray areas, but still. Even in your circle of friends, people make fun of you.
Number 7. Even in your circle of friends, some people make fun of you.
Okay, but people making fun of you could be a sign that they actually like you. All right, so for example, at work, you know, people will talk shit to me and be like, you know, call me names and stuff, and I dish it right back to them because, well, I like them too and want to freaking prove a point that you're not going to hurt my feelings just by calling me a name or making fun of me. I'm going to hurt your feelings, or we're just all going to laugh together and have a good time, which ends up being the case most of the time. So, I mean, it's just like a couple of friends going up to each other, shaking hands, high-fiving and saying, like, what's up, you dirty dog? And they're like, oh, nothing, you ugly pig. I don't know. Whatever it is, you know, guy friends say to each other. To, like, insult them. But it doesn't mean they hate each other. It just means that, you know, they're friends. That's what they do. Well, listen, guys, I don't want to make this any longer than it already is. But, yeah, you guys can watch the rest of this video by PewDiePie called Are You a Beta Male on his channel. And, yeah, this is a pretty fun little video because, well, to be perfectly honest, the whole alpha male, beta male ideas are just total shit. I think they're stupid, honestly, because it doesn't matter if you're an alpha male or beta male, whatever. All it comes down to is, do you have confidence and how do you carry yourself? Are you respectable? And are you happy? That's the bottom line. Are you happy? All right, guys, you take care. This is BP signing out.